I started learning sarod at Allauddin College of Music in the year 1968. I come from a musical family. My mother was very famous. My uncles, one of my maternal uncles used to play sarod, one used to play tabla and other instruments. From my childhood days, I have seen musical soirees in our house, and also I heard the name of the famous musicians, and also I heard the 78 RPM records of the famous musicians. In that way, the name Allauddin Khan Sahab stuck in my mind from my childhood. In the year 1970, he fell very sick in Maihar, and the senior students of Aliyabad College of Music, Calcutta, went to see him. I was supposed to go with them to see Baba Allauddin Khan Sahab, but I couldn't because I used to study in a missionary school, where every Friday we used to have examinations. So my parents didn't allow so that I be barred from appearing the examinations. So I couldn't go. So that's a big lament in my life, that was the only chance I got to see Baba Allauddin Khan Sahab. But later on, when I became very close to his son, Ustad Allauddin Khan Sahab, and his grandsons, Ustad Aashish Khan, Ustad Danish Khan, and others, I almost, what I have learned and heard about Baba Allauddin Khan Sahab from them, it seems that I've seen him, I've almost touched him, or maybe I almost talked with him. Later on, I started reading books, articles on him, and from that, I came to know a lot about him. So this is a small introduction, you can see the way I came to know about Baba Allauddin Khan. The contribution of Baba Allauddin Khan in the world of music is mammoth. It's so vast that in a short time it is very difficult to explain. But still we'll try whatever we can explain or analyze his musical contribution. First we'll go with the instrument, his contribution in the modern sarod which we play these days, and especially in the Maiha Senia Karan. The instrument I am holding on my lap is the modern Maiha Senia Karana sarod. This design was developed by Baba Allauddin Khan Sahab. Earlier the sarod was different, which I will show you later on. This sarod, with the help of his brother Ustad Ayat Ali Khan, he designed and developed. If we go back, then we will find the different sarods were being played, which were almost totally different from this modern sarod. Let's see one of those old sarods. Actually, this present sarod is amalgamation of four instruments, which I will trying to show you and explain how Allauddin Khan Sahab took ideas from all those four instruments and incorporated and made this modern sarod. This instrument is called Afghani Rabab or Kabuli Rabab. You can see this instrument has got a long belly with electrical sound box, and the strings used in this instrument are of cat guts or nylon strings, not metal strings. Only in the sympathetic strings are metal. This is a very popular instrument in the Middle East and especially in the northern India like Kashmir, Afghanistan and other places. There was another instrument called Sharud in the Persia and also in Afghanistan area. Sharud means music. That instrument is little bigger than this Kabuli Rabab. Generally, the folk musics were being played on this Kabuli Rabab. Later on, when these Afghanist people came to India and they heard the Indian classical music, then they started learning Indian raga music and tried to play the raga music on their Kabuli Rabab. Now, when they found that it is very difficult to play the means, the glissandos, which I'll show you later, to play on this rabab or in sarud, they were thinking of making something in which they can play the Indian classical music. I mean, they were trying to make a new instrument where they can play the Indian classical music. So in that process, the earlier sarod came, which is like this. This is the old type sarod. Again, you see that belly is quite, the depth of the belly is quite big. Again, it's like horseshoe shape, the drum or the sound box, elliptical shape. But instead of cat gut strings, there are steel and copper wires. And in rabab, the fingerboard is made out of wood, whereas over here it's plain. So, because of some development, some evolution, this prototype sarod came after the Afghani rabab. But there were problems in playing this kind of instruments. Because of the long belly, you have to hold your hand in such a way that after 10-20 minutes of playing, your hands used to get stuck, numbness used to come. And later on it was found among many musicians that they started suffering from arthritis. But once again I will say how this plate came in the sarod. How do they think this plate came? In order to explain that, I have to take another instrument which is known as Sursingar. So let's see that Sursingar instrument which influenced making of this old type of sarod. This is called Rabab. This instrument was very popular at the time of Mughal Empire. Tansen, Mia Tansen, the court musician of Akbar, used to play this rabab and used to sing Drupal. Later on, he changed the design of this instrument. And what he made, that picture I will show you. So he changed little bit of the photo of the rabab which I showed you earlier, and made this type of rabab. And after he started playing this rabab, after his name Tansen, this rabab used to be called as Senia rabab. It is made out of wood and there is a parchment or goat skin. The fingerboard is wooden. There were six pegs, and again earlier times it was played, the strings were made out of cat guts, Later on, when the cat guts are not found, then they used to put plastic string. That is in the modern time. But this instrument has totally extinct. It was Baba Allauddin Khan who learned this instrument from Wazir Khan, and he was the last exponent of this Senya Rabab. I can show some other pictures also. In the Mughal time, this instrument was used to be played while standing, holding it on the shoulder like this way. Khan is holding the Senya Rabab. He was a left-handed. That is not the issue, but it is the position how this instrument is to be played. The name of this instrument is called Sur Singa. This instrument evolved from a fight between two musicians in the later part of 18th century. Nirmal Shah was a very famous bean player, hailed from Senya family. He was court musician at the Darbar of Kashi Naresh, that is at the King Udit Narayan Singh of Benares. In his Darbar, Nirmal Shah used to play Binkar. There was another Rabab player, very famous from the same Senya Gharana, was Jafar Khan, who was also a court musician in Udit Narayan Singh's Darbar. Once in the monsoon time, Udit Narayan Singh asked these two musicians to play Raag Miyaki Malla, the monsoon raag. Nirmal Shah played all the nuances of Miyaki Malla, and he sounded so good that he got lots of applause from the audience while playing this raag. But later on, when Jafar Khan was used to ask to play this raag, he couldn't play properly because at that time the parchment or the skin of his rabab got slack and a very damp noise came out from his instrument. So he was shattered because he couldn't play properly, and audience also didn't like or give any proper applause. So what he did, he requested the king, Udit Narayan Singh, that Maharaj, can you give me some time? I will make an instrument, new instrument, and in that instrument I will play the same raag properly so that it can please your ear. So he took 1 month's time and made this instrument Sur Singa. So what he did, he took the idea from the Senya Rabab, the picture you have seen earlier. Instead of making the full instrument wood, he took the lower part, that is the sound box, made out of gold. Then he put the steel plate over here for playing, and instead of cat gut strings like rabab, he put six metal strings for playing main strings, for playing the main notes, and drone strings, three drone strings. Though I have put a new, another drone string over here, which is my idea, however. And then he started playing, started calling it as Sur Singa, and started playing. What happened? In Senya Rabab, not much glissando on me, like, or sustainability of note was not there, because it was being played on cat guard and the fingerboard was wooden. Because of steel string and steel plate, there are lot more sustainability of notes and long means can be played in the Sur Singa. So to play an Indian raga on this kind of instrument became easier and sounded much better. So after the invention there of sud singer, the sarod player started putting finger steel plate on their sarod, and also they changed their strings from catgut to steel strings, and thus this old sarod came. Now if we look back to Baba Alauddin Khan Talim period, that is while he was learning from all the great maestros, we find that he learned almost all kinds of instruments from them. He learned sarod, he learned sur singa, he learned senia rabab. But from the very, he was a very famous violinist also. But from the beginning, he was searching for a modern instrument, an instrument where all things, all the aspects of instrumental music can be played, and also all the aspects of Dhrupad music or Raga music can be played. He was also looking for a particular tone so that that tone will help the instrument sing or speak fluently, just like we talk. Also his vocal background, he learned vocal music for 7 years, so he also wanted to incorporate the vocal style on the instrument. So he was searching for an instrument. As he learned all the 4 instruments which I showed you earlier, he got an idea. With the help of his brother Ayat Ali Khan, he designed a sarod, and this is that sarod where he cut down the length of the belly little shorter. Instead of the elliptical size of the drum, he made it more roundish like senia rabab. Then he took 4 strings from the sur singa on the upper neck, though he used to play a 5th string as a lower pancham string for playing the Drupadang alap. But later on, from when he made an instrument for his son Ali Akbar Khan, he took it away. So in the olden sarod, there was no these brass gourds. The gourds are made out of this tumma we call, they're made out of gourds, that is the lau we call, from that fruit. But he found that if we put brass gourds, then the more resonance will come. Earlier, the tarab strings were much less in the olden sarod. There were either 9 or 11. But here he put 15 tarab strings or sympathetic strings so that he could tune according to the ragas and almost covering 2-3 octaves. Earlier, sarods were being played, I'll show you, with plectrums made out of wire, where metallic sounds used to come, like thought that this metallic sound is not good for ear, it's not sounds good for listening also. So he started making, we call this plectrum as Java. It is from the Persian word Java. Java, made from coconut shells, which sound is much better, like. And he used to play various shapes, various thickness of this Java, and started playing. This instrument became so versatile that any kind of music can be played on this instrument, which in the earlier sarod was not being played. On top of that, because he learned not only the Dhrupad music, he also learned Khyal, Thumri, other songs, and he used to compose music for the band when he was in Rampur at the time of learning from Uzair Khan. He used to make compositions. So he found that it was very difficult to play all the styles, all the passages to play on this old type of sarod. So that's why he made this one, this type of sarod, and he started playing in this sarod. And so this sarod became so versatile that you could play all kind of exercises and patterns and everything and nuances on this modern sarod. So this is a big contribution in the Indian music, instrumental music, and especially in the sarod playing music. Earlier the sarod players specialized on certain passages. Like if you want to hear good giridiri tan, you have to go a certain person because he is famous for playing giridiri tan. If you want to hear a good composition, you have to go someone else. If you want to hear gamak tan or gamak, you have to go someone else. So it was very difficult to find everything to be played on sarod by one man. But it is because of Baba Allauddin Khan, he learned all the instruments. Especially, he didn't learn the bin actually, but he learned the playing of bin, the technique of bin on Sursinga. And he incorporated all this Senia Rabab style, the Kabuli Rabab style, the Sursinga style of technique and playing style, he incorporated in this sarod and gave a new dimension to the sarod playing. Earlier, someone could play Krintan like this. But it was Baba Allauddin Khan Sahib who started. Also, it was very difficult at that time to play Krintan on that kind of old sarod, because of technical defect. As he was a prolific composer, he used to compose different types of gods. Whatever he learned, whatever he didn't learn, he used to get ideas from everywhere, and he used to make different compositions. So in his developed sarod, he experimented with all those gods and made those gods very popular. In olden times, mostly the sarod players used to play small alaps followed by a very fast composition of god in tinta. But Allauddin Khan, because of his dhrupad training, he started playing all the dhrupad style alap, and that becomes, there are 13 or 18 parts of alap which he incorporated in playing in his own style. It was easier because he made this instrument in such a comfortable way that it was much easier to play this all these passages very comfortably. Earlier, in the earlier sarod, it was not being able to be played in earlier sarod comfortably. So that is another big contribution. That made the sarod, this modern sarod, a very versatile thing. Earlier I mentioned that his contribution in the instrumental music. But actually, if we further analyze his music, then we will find that it's not only in instrumental music. His contribution was also in the vocal music and also in the dance music. When he was in the troupe of Uday Shankar, the famous dancer, he used to compose music for Uday Shankar ji's ballet. So those music were meant for dance. So he had a great idea about dance, and that's why he could make all those compositions, so that on the basis of those compositions, ballets and dance can be performed. So that is another contribution. Then in the earlier times, there was mostly Dhrupad was very popular. They used to sing alap followed by a dhamar or any Chautal composition, Dhrupad composition sang by the Dhrupadiyas. Even the Khyaliyas, the old Khyaliyas from the Gwalior Gharna, they used to sing big alaps or followed by a Madhalay composition, Khyal composition. But after Baba's, this Binkar style elaborated alap, the Bilambit, the slow alap, then the Madh alap or the middle alap, then followed by the Jod alap, that is the connecting alap, then the fast alap, that is the Drut alap. So
all being combined and in an alap was being followed by the vocalist also. They also started singing in khyal same way. The bilambit or slow alap, the middle or the mad alap, and the fast alap, that is the bistar, which is followed like tans, I mean. So that also Allauddin Khan Sam's playing technique influenced the vocalist also. Also he composed lots of taranas, which was very popular at that time, and based on the most of the vocal song, because he learned so much vocal music from his guru Gopal Chandra Chakravarti. Though he was a very devout Muslim, he used to read namaz 5 times a day, but he was also Hindu at the time because of his ancestors who were Hindus. He had same respect for all kind of religion. If you go through his songs, the compositions he wrote, you will find that he has mentioned the name of Allah, the name of Prophet, the name of Krishna, the name of Ganesh, the name of Jesus. Everything in his compositions you will find. He was the most secular musician we ever found. Lastly, his contribution to the society was enormous. Earlier days, the ustads or the gurus, they didn't like teaching their students, I mean properly in the sense they used to conceal their knowledge. They were not free-minded to give all what they have learned to give to the students. It was Allauddin Khan Sahab, because he started in learning all those compositions and all these materials, all the musical materials, that he tried to keep it. He tried to teach his students, not only his own son, daughters or his close relatives, but he also tried teaching all his students so that this thing can be kept ever after. I mean, if you don't disclose anything, then it will vanish. So which he didn't like, so he, with his open-minded, he taught everybody whatever he learned. He tried. It depend on the students whether they could take it or not. He was such a talented person that he could read the mind of the students. So that's why he knew what to be taught to the students. So that's why he taught his students every other student in other way. He taught Ravi Shankar ji in one way, he taught Nikhil Banerjee in another way, he taught his son Ali Akbar Khan Sahib in one way, he taught his nephew Bahadur Khan Sahib in another way. But all what he taught, that made them stalwarts because of the style. Because of so many styles he knew, that's why he distributed these styles among his students, which is a very thought-provoking thing in the world of music. So in a very short time, it is very difficult to explain, analyze or to tell about the contribution of Baba Allauddin Khan in the music world. With my meager knowledge, I tried my level best to say few words on Baba Allauddin Khan. My great respect to him, my pranam to him. Thank you.